So a couple videos back, I told you guys that I would be taking a vacation in California to spend time with my family, and I did just that. I had an absolutely amazing time, and it was definitely hard to say goodbye. Although my family was my main priority, I definitely got to experience some fishy things. And among that is, I got to go to SeaWorld. I got to see orcas for the first time in real life, and if you don't know, orcas are my favorite animals, and when I saw them, it definitely touched me deep down inside. But one other thing I got to do was I got to go to a place called Coast Gym USA. I found out about Coast Gym on YouTube. The Pond Digger actually lives in California as well, and he actually got to team up with them for a video or two. So I saw that location was about 45 to an hour away from where I was at. I definitely wanted to check it out. I really didn't get to stay long. I was with my family and my little niece was definitely tired that time of the day. But the time I did get to experience was absolutely amazing. When you walk in, you're greeted with African cichlids. They had nothing but show quality peacocks. They had another range of fish, from your South American cichlids, from your discus to your angelfish, and some geophagus and such. They also specialized in betas. They had an arrangement of fancy betas and even the giants. To the right of the store, they also had a couple, I believe, 40-gallon Planet tanks in a row. But the main priority while I was going there were the goldfish. I didn't get to get much film because my camera was croaking. Go figure, you go on vacation, your camera gives out. When I walked back to the goldfish section, I had high expectations. And let me tell you, they were met. I take that back. Everything in the store was amazing. It's not too often you go into a local fish store and you see them catering to the more experienced. From what I got to know from them, quality is definitely one of their pet peeves. So when I walked back to the goldfish section, my jaw hit the floor. They had everything you could think of, from amazing Ryukins to Apache Arandas to butterfly telescopes to Ranchus. Everything you could think of was there, and they all looked amazing. I saw a lot that I wanted to take home. And I could have bought a lot more home than I did, but I limited myself. I'm definitely gonna be a repeat customer. So what I chose were a couple different fish. I took two Ryukin calicos home. I got three different Arandas. I got two red caps, which are common, but it's my favorite Aranda, and possibly my favorite goldfish. I got a black Aranda, and I got two telescopes. So you see that bubble eye in the bag? That's my absolute favorite fish out of the pool. When I saw that fish at the bottom of the tote, I said, whoop, that's it. I want that fish. I'm getting that fish. Give me the net, guys. I scooped him up, and I put him in the little strainer basket. As you guys can see, I am a little puzzled right here in the video. It's no biggie. Coast Gym actually forgot to send a fish. I did not panic. I looked over the invoice, make sure everything was all right, and I was correct. There was a Ryukin that was missing. Unfortunately, it was one of the prettier Ryukins. So what I did is I got online, I went to Facebook.com, and I contacted the crew over at Coastal Gym, and I said, hey, you know, I got my fish in, but one of the fish was missing. They asked me which one was missing. I said, it's one of the Calico Ryukins. I said, I have a picture on my camera. Do you want me to send that to you? After they received the photo that I sent them through my iPhone, they went ahead and pulled the Ryukin from their stock tank. They snapped a photo and sent it back to me. I then verified that that was the fish that I picked out. The crew informed me that they would send it out the next Monday. So, calmly and patiently, I waited. Sure enough, Monday morning came, I heard a knock at my door, I looked on the step, and there was a box with live fish on it. As you guys can see, there are already a few fish in the 75-gallon aquarium. The reason for that is because these are the fish from the first batch. I decided to go ahead and not show you that because of two reasons. One, it's just fish floating in a bag, and I'm doing the same thing here. When I'm acclimating my goldfish, I like to float the bag for a minimum of 30 minutes. That way the temperature can stabilize. Then I open the bag and immediately grab it with my hand that's been pre-cleaned, and I firmly but gently grasp the fish and I introduce it into the aquarium and carefully monitor it. That's a debatable topic, and I've got a video coming up in the future on when to use and how to use different practices of acclimations. There are different ways of doing it, and there's appropriate times on when to use those different methods. The second reason I didn't show you guys the acclimation of the original fish is because I had two that didn't pull through, and I didn't feel like it was necessary to show those fish suffering. Coach Jim actually sent me a message checking up on the fish and how everything was going. I greatly appreciate that. It's a great customer service. But it was regretful to inform them on what was going on. Even though this aquarium was built for goldfish and the hang on the back filters were imported from 125 gallon with loads of beneficial bacteria, and the tank was cycled and it had a few couple plants in there to absorb nutrients, I had a couple fish that didn't make it. One of the calico Ryukins and the black Aranda didn't pull through. Even though I tried everything at my disposal to reverse those effects, the fish didn't pull through. And it was definitely a sad thing to see happen, but that's in the past. I'm doing everything now to focus on these fish and to give them the life they deserve. As you guys can see, I've got some live plants in the aquarium. I know there's going to be a lot of red flags going up right now. Wayne, you can't have live plants in a goldfish aquarium. The fish are going to eat the plants, they're going to uproot them, so on and so forth. Live plants in a goldfish aquarium isn't as hard as it makes it out to be. I don't want to get off topic of this video because I am going to be doing a video on planting this aquarium and we're going to go into detail. This is a clip from that video that's going to be coming out in the future. When you're selecting plants for goldfish, I do want to touch on it briefly. You definitely want to choose plants that are unlikely to be eaten or consumed or digged up by goldfish. Now, originally, I wasn't even going to introduce live plants into this aquarium. When looking over the benefits live plants can provide, I decided to go that route for a couple different reasons. One, live plants are a sponge. They absorb nutrients or waste in the aquarium water column. Even though this aquarium is built for goldfish, filtration is strong, I've got heavy oxygen levels, and I've got a substrate that is more than able to provide beneficial bacteria for the amount of bio load I have in this aquarium, I wanted to make sure I had a fall safe. There's always going to be something in my life that pulls me away from my aquariums. These plants can definitely be a fall safe, and what I mean by that is they're going to be absorbing the waste. Now, I'm going to go into detail in the future why I chose Crips. This is by no means the final outcome of the aquascape. Even though these fish have been in there a couple weeks now, I don't want to get in there and move things around just yet. I'm definitely going to be introducing different species of plants and readjusting the aquascape as I see fit for myself and the fish. But I feel as if I get in there now and I start moving things around, the fish are never going to become accustomed to their environment and they're not going to establish trust with me. I must say, it's amazing to have a fancy goldfish aquarium again. You guys know that I've had a lot of koi over the years, but fancy goldfish, I haven't embarked on them in years, probably before my YouTube channel. Another thing I'm really excited about with fancy goldfish is this opens a whole nother door for my channel. I can't wait to start making videos for goldfish. Now, I am going to be giving you guys a little bit of a sneak peek in this video. I promised myself I won't start this aquarium until this aquarium is done. Now, goldfish does not end with this aquarium. I'm going to be doing some incredible things with goldfish in the future. But I am going to be starting an African cichlid aquarium. I gave some hints in my past description and over on Facebook.com. People have been asking me to do African cichlids for the longest time, and I finally decided that I'm going to embark on African cichlids once more. But until next time, guys, I hope you liked this simple but rewarding video. I hope you tune in for the next video. Comment, rate, and subscribe. I've been Wayne with Wayne's Fish World. Later.